the animation seminar with Michael Polvani, and he's gonna. He has a long career, 28 years in the industry. He's worked on films like Hercules and Iron Giant, and he's here to talk with you today about animation, give you some tips and tricks, and have you ask questions and kind of get a little bit of his experience. So everybody, welcome, Mike.
Thanks for coming out. I wanted to start off by showing you guys my demo reel. So you just who is this guy? I just want to let you guys know right up front that this is very, very informal, very casual. So if you have any questions, you know, about anything along the way, just go for it, raise your hand. If I'm like, you know, in the middle of something, just say, whatever. So I'll kick it off by showing the demo reel. This isn't everything that I've worked on, because you can't fit everything for so long, but this will just give you a little cross-section of the stuff I've worked on.
And the Oscar goes to...
Hi! Thanks! It was getting stuffy in there. And the Oscar goes to Manipulation, Daniel Greaves.
You're in the pool.
Every scene.
Thank you.
Gubbies. What's that? One more time. Gubbies. Ride a roller coaster.
double character. I was surprised when I saw this, but I didn't realize he worked this rough. You know, this one in the upper left here, this one in the middle. They're just almost stick figures. They're just like gestural things on the surface for the head, which is a great way to work because it's so easy to make changes right away. You know, that's any time labor or pose. Just get it down really fast and work it. Most of these are kind of finished. This is kind of rough. All these pigs are a great example of that. Just treat it as a little shape, like a little sausage. These are great. Famous animator Fred Gordon games. This looks like it's not posted.
I
straight ahead thing. Normally, you guys are familiar with straight ahead posted posts, right? In general, we use posted posts for acting stuff. We use straight ahead for movement, like jumping, running, walking, things like that. In general, you can use poses for walking too, but if you want to get a real fluid walk, I would suggest trying to do it straight ahead. Show you. Okay, this is really important. This illustrates all the different, well, just gives you an idea of some of the different possibilities of doing breakdown drawings. Here's an example of two different extremes. Here's one that's just normal and goes down like this. So I went ahead and broke down all different layers. Like, here's one way to get down to that pose is through the spring. It anticipates up and down. There's another way. Goes back like this.
Yep.
This is just a little straight out of different ways. This, what I would do is, you can see this big chart over here, it's like a bunch of triangles. I went from here all the way over to this dot right here. And I did all the poses that were his arms up like this. So that one, that one, that one. I just did them straight across all the way over to the last one right there. Then I went back in, altered in between. Those and have the arms go down like that. So after this, I want to put that one in, just in between it all the way across, just adjust it like the legs and arms go down, and so kind of see how it plays out. It's really nice stagger. Thank you.
chipped out of granite, that's me.
You won't take my case, won't you?
Not a chance.
What do you mean, not a chance?
Another thing, you tone down that goofiness. If you want my help, you act like a human. You understand?
Yes, sir. But wouldn't it be more helpful if I started to came along with you? Maybe because what if maybe you gotta get into some of the smart locks or something? Okay.
This breaks down how you build a character. For example, when I started animating this bird flapping, I just did that. Just this little cyclic little worm thing. Right? It doesn't look like much. But when you start adding stuff in, like the wings, you start doing this. And I add a little legs in there. Expression first, there we go. It's an easy expression in the tail that we're patching his eyes. So it's starting to look pretty complicated, right? But you saw how it started out. Really simple. A little tuft of hair. There it is. It's purple. It's like a little... how this stuff builds up. Real simple, right? As long as you keep it simple, you can always get stuff to get out of here. Just as long as you get an idea of what you want that primary movement to be, and all this other stuff is extra. Always underneath where you're working, keep it consistent. I just draw the two portions here. twigs that just don't grow any bird panels. Just about a couple of splits for them.
I triple dog dare you!